Good morning. Streaming on Peacock is the game series, The Traitors.
Deep in the Scottish Highlands, there's a castle where the faithful reside. Their goal? Win $250,000. But hidden amongst them are three traitors.
Contestants in the game move into a majestic castle and work as a team to complete a series of dramatic and challenging missions to earn money for the prize pot. However, some contestants are traitors and some are loyal. I chatted with contestant Kate Chastain.
The rules of the game, was that explained to you in full or did you learn as you were going?
The rules of the game were explained to us in full when we first got to the castle, but it was all very overwhelming. So I think everyone there would agree that we were also learning as we were going. I'm not sure some of us ever really mastered the game.
For all its flash, location, and stylized camera work, The Traitors is basically a Survivor clone and works very hard to get contestants to butt heads and argue, and ends up being a rather empty waste of time. Again, it's streaming on Peacock and gets a D. It's rated TV-14. Streaming on Netflix is the adventure film True Spirit.
That boat is a shockingly tiny thing to send a child to sea in.
They are waiting for her to fail.
She cannot come limping back in.
Red sky at night, sailor's delight. Red sky in the morning, sailor's warning.
Based on the true story of Jessica Watson, who sets out to be the youngest person to sail solo, nonstop, and unassisted around the world. I chatted with Jessica and the film star, Tegan Croft.
Did they get it right, pretty much?
Absolutely. I mean, some little details, of course, movie magic, but the essence of it and the message and the inspiration for me, I think, is there.
Tegan, when accepting a role like this that you know you're going to be, on a boat and wet, does that bother you? Are you scared of the ocean?
Look, to be honest, I doing the call back with the casting and the directors and stuff, I was a bit scared of waves, but I made sure not to tell them. But once I got on the boat and started to learn to sail and, started really filming, it's just fun. It's great to challenge yourself physically like that and, to pick up a new skill and find a new love and find a new, something that you can enjoy. And now I can go out with my granddad on a boat, maybe, It's something really nice that I was able to do. So just positives all the way.
True Spirit is a terrific family adventure film about support, survival, and following your dream. Again, it's streaming exclusively on Netflix and gets an A. It's not rated. In selected theaters is M. Night Shyamalan's horror thriller, Knock at the Cabin.
There is a woman carrying something that looks like a pick with a chain and a mallet head.
You see, the four of us have a very important job to do. In fact, it might be the most important job in the history of the world.
While vacationing, a little girl and her parents are taken hostage by armed strangers who demand that the family make a choice to avert the apocalypse.
Man, this character is really, he's weighted. And there's all the chunky dialogue, and I was like, this is an opportunity of a lifetime. This is what I've been waiting for, because roles like this don't get offered to guys like me. I'm typically, everybody wants me for action stuff, and they kind of, I've kind of been fighting to get out of that box, but people naturally, and I understand why, want to put me in that box, because I fit the bill, and I'm good at action. I play that guy, I can be that guy, but I want the deeper roles because I want to prove myself as an actor.
Knock at the Cabin offers up a terrific performance by Dave Bautista, who carries the film pretty much on his own. However, the film is a bit confusing and, by the final reel, leaves the audience wanting a more rewarding ending. Again, Knock at the Cabin is playing in selected theaters and gets a B. It's rated R. For ABC4, I'm film critic Tony Toscano.